Worship comes from the present prevalent power that resides in us. So what do you mean? You mean this man who's person that's been infiltrated with the devil have come to worship Jesus? Sounded a lot, didn't it? Sounded a lot, didn't it? Maybe that was a struggle. Well, maybe that was a struggle between the spirit of the man and this evil spirit. No, not the case. The text says that when he saw Jesus, a great way off, he ran down and worshiped him. Notice what he says when he bows down, he said, What have I to do with you, Jesus? You remember what happened on the water? They said, what manner of man is this? They were amazed. They were in awe. But this other fellow, who's so messed up with the stuff inside of him, recognizes who Jesus is. He says, what do I have to do with you, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High God? I beg of you by God that you torment me not. Turn torment me. He wouldn't say, I heard me, Jesus. He was saying, I know that hell is my ultimate destination. I know I've got to go there, but I'm not ready to go. Don't banish me just yet. Jesus says to him, he says, come out of the man. You unclean spirit. Come out of the man. Jesus recognized who's talking. And he says, come out of the man, you unclean spirit. I wish I had time tonight. Come out of the man, you unclean spirit. And then he turns around and says, what is your name? Now listen. We don't need to spend our energies trying to delve into demonology and determine what kind of demon. You leave that in the hands of Jesus. Spend our energy trying to figure out, Dr. Washington, what kind of demon is that? Listen. When I was a child, we sang a song, Satan, we're going to tear your kingdom down. Yeah, that's what you say. They don't sing it much anymore. Don't say that much anymore. We say so, Satan, you can build your kingdom all over this land, but oh, Satan, we're going to tear your kingdom down. Now, listen, understand, when we sang the song, we understood we mean God first, then us. Don't ever think that you got it so together, that you have grown so, that you're so heavy, that you're so deep, that you can handle the devil by yourself. If you go up trying to handle him, I dare you, he'll tell you new.
About
their financial loss. So here they come. Because the record says he told them what had happened. But when they came to give Jesus a piece of their mind. You know how we are about our stuff. We come to our stuff, we'll get into it. Often suggestion to the Christian community, be careful about being so quick to give people a piece of your mind. Because you may not have as much mind as you think you have. They came to give Jesus a piece of their mind. But when they got there, notice, I pray that you read the entire text when you get to yourself. When they got there, they could not help but see the man who had once been possessed with a legion of demons. They came to tell Jesus off. The Bible said when they got there, they saw him who was possessed sitting, clothed, and in his right mind. And I get ready to leave you. I just want to lift what the Lord has done for you. They came to tell Jesus off. But they saw him sitting, clothed, and in his right mind. Well, men may want to deny the power of our Christ, but they cannot deny the work of our Christ. Who else can take a life from the gutter or from the cesspools of iniquity? Clean him up and clean him out. Who else can take prostitutes and make them missionaries? Who else can take alcoholics and drug addicts and make them heralds for the Lord? Are you praying with me? They may want to deny him, but they can never deny his word. I said to you three things the Lord did for him. Number one, he tranquilized him. At the outset, the man is found running up to the mountains and down to the tombs, up to the mountain and down to the tombs, up to the mountains and down to the tombs. Jesus tranquilized him. The next thing the Lord did for him was he civilized him. Remember I told you, he was a nudist exhibitionist. He was a streaker. He ran around with no clothes on. But they see him now sitting and he is all so clothed. The third thing the Lord did for him was he intellectualized him. Remember that he was running up to the mountains, down to the tomb with no clothes on, cutting himself and crying both night and day. But when they see him, he's sitting, he's clothed, and now he's in his right mind. Well, it would seem that these men would come and rejoice at what the Lord has done. But they only thinking about their commerce, and they ask the Lord to leave their show. Well, my brothers and my sister, it's a dangerous thing to ask the Lord out of your faith. Because never again is it recorded in the Holy Writ that Jesus ever returned to Gennesaret. Yes, you ought to have been understanding, ought to seek the Lord while he may be found. I'm about to take my seat, but as Jesus went on,